Sometimes, exploring means finally visiting a place you've researched and read about for years. I'm author and researcher Mike Luoma. My summer 2021 road trip brought me to Peebles, Ohio, and a place I'd long been learning of in books and videos, Serpent Mound. This Native American effigy mound resembles a great serpent, uncoiling at seven coils atop a bluff near Brush Creek in southwest Ohio. Over 1,400 feet long, it's the largest effigy mound in North America and the largest serpent effigy in the world. It was once likely taller, maybe 5 feet high. Climbing to the top of an old steel tower at the site gives you an overhead view of the serpent. Its spiral, three-coiled tail is to the left. Its head on the distant end of the coils to the right, with an oval held in its open jaws, thought to be an egg or a frog. We'll see it close up in a bit. Awesome, in every sense of the word. Ephraim Squire and Edwin Davis provided one of the earliest modern reports of Serpent Mound. This illustration appeared in their 1848 book for the Smithsonian, Ancient Monuments of the Mississippi Valley. Squire wrote at the time that Serpent Mound was little known outside its immediate area, and, quote, "no plan or description has hitherto been published," end quote. Now it's a National Historic Landmark. A paved path follows the perimeter of the mound. There's also a hiking trail leading through the woods around the bluff. I enjoyed the lucky luxury of having the site nearly to myself for almost an hour, so we can take a nice long look around. Thank you. Videography and photography can be modern approaches to acknowledging, appreciating, and respecting a site. I find they help slow me down, help me really look into a place, not simply see it superficially. And sharing the video with you then becomes another piece of the acknowledgement, appreciation, and respect. The coils of the Serpent Mound are said to be astronomically aligned to sunrise on the equinoxes and solstices. And I checked sunset on the equinoxes and winter solstice with the Sunseeker app. The head of the serpent points directly at the summer solstice sunset. Some lunar alignments have been suggested here as well. Down here near the head, we see how the jaws open to encompass the oval. Thank you. We have Harvard University's Frederick Ward Putnam to thank for preserving Serpent Mound. After finding it and discovering it was threatened in the 1880s, he helped orchestrate the Peabody Museum's purchase of the site, now in the hands of the Ohio History Connection. The serpent ends with its tail coiling around itself three times. Some suggest this means it's a rattlesnake. I find the spiral design curious, universal. How old is Serpent Mound? Good question. The answer's not settled. Some archaeologists favor dating that places it around 1000 AD with the Fort Ancient culture, Ohio's contemporaries of the Mississippians who built Cahokia. Newer and older evidence suggested an Edina origin, maybe as early as 250 BC. Though now a National Historic Landmark, Serpent Mound still isn't that well known. Like Cahokia, Serpent Mound seems to be one of the best-kept secrets in American history. Impressive ancient accomplishments of Native Americans are just ignored. We are unaware of the ancient history that happened all around us. How much has been lost? Erased, ethnically cleansed. How much is still ignored right now? How much remains which we don't even know are remains? Even the past known to us is left unheralded. But maybe these kind of videos will help people realize just what seems to be hiding in plain sight. There are other mounds nearby. An Edina Mound's excavation uncovered a copper breastplate, stone axes and points, and grooved pieces of sandstone. There are Fort Ancient Mounds here, too. Always looking to see what else might be nearby, I checked out the woodland trail around the bluff and found the creek below and a small cave. The cave was the most interesting thing along the bluff. but the large spider population prompted me to zoom in rather than climb up into the cave. The trail just seemed to end, so I retraced my way back up the bluff to the Serpent Mound. I also made a trip around the Serpent Mound without my camera and phone, just to take it in. In the end, part of me didn't really want to leave. But as the afternoon grew hotter and more people arrived, it became time to finally go, loaded up with memories and the experience, and pictures and video, too. I'm Mike Luoma. Thank you for experiencing Serpent Mound with me.